What's up, guys?
Hey, Monty.
How are we doing?
Doing great.
Good. Look at
2 weeks since hiring Jonathan. How close are you guys to completing the staff?
We are very close. We're very close, almost completely done. We'll be able to announce that here shortly. It's been great. We got a lot of new faces in the building. Had a chance to get everybody together as a staff last week for the first time, kind of get a state of the union of what to expect this week at the combine and roles and responsibility. And it was great to have everybody in a room for the most part, almost everybody last week for the first time.
How would you describe your quarterback situation right now?
Hey, Ben. How are you? Good to see you, man. I'd say Kyler's been in the building the last couple of weeks, working his butt off. He's attacking his rehab. It's been great to see him. Great to see him be able to get introduced to some of the new coaches, have conversations with them, say hi. Our main focus is getting Kyler healthy and getting him back out on the field as quickly and getting him back to doing the things that we know he can do. As it pertains to anything else, we'll look at all positions on the team, whether it's quarterback or any other, and if there's a chance to add competition, add depth, we'll certainly take a look at that as well.
Adding competition makes sense given that Kyler, you don't know when he's going
to
be ready.
I think adding competition to everywhere on the roster always makes sense. And so whether we're talking specifically about the quarterback position or any other, we're going to always look to improve the depth and the competition on our team, because that's just going to push all of our players to get better. And so that's something we're going to look at every position.
Monty, where situation that you guys specifically are getting ready to delve into full throttle?
Yeah.
What's that going to be like?
Yeah, absolutely. So a couple of weeks ago we had a chance to meet with our pro staff and go through our unrestricted free agency meetings. It was a great week. Just going through our evaluations of the players. You know, there'll be further discussions happening here in the coming weeks of just where there might be availability for us to add players. And again, I'll go back to whatever's the best to improve the team, to improve depth, improve competition, we're going to look to do that. But knowing that obviously we can't go out and pay everybody, there's rules and everybody's faced with the same issues. So we're gonna make decisions that are best for the team where we can improve and add depth.
Now with Zach Allen and Byron Murphy in terms of potentially bringing them back?
Yeah, absolutely. So Zach and Byron are both good players. We'd love to keep them. There's obviously going to be a financial component, a business component that comes into that. Those discussions will continue to take place over the next couple weeks as we approach the start of the league year. And you know, those are things that there's always we'd love to keep everybody. We'd love to pay everybody. And unfortunately, the way the league's set up, that's not always possible. But those discussions certainly are going to continue to take place.
Have you guys made a decision on Isaiah Simmons' fifth year?
Right here.
You're in the early stages of evaluating DeAndre's future with the franchise.
Yep.
Any progress there or any discussions with other teams about the league you might have interest?
I've had a conversation with DeAndre and DeAndre's representative. Those have been very productive conversations. You know, I've watched from afar the last 10 years or whatever it's been with DeAndre and have been on teams that have had to compete against him. I've seen the player that DeAndre is and what he can do on the field, and I know he's tough to defend. And so, you know, I'm glad that he's on the team. And you know, I think with him or with, as it goes to any player, those are situations that we'll address as they come up. But I'm glad DeAndre is on the team right now, and I'm happy to be on the same team with him.
Monty, have you guys made a decision on Isaiah Simmons' fifth-year option yet?
We're working through that. So Isaiah, you know, we're the defensive staff is in their process of evaluating the roster and where guys fit and positionally where guys are going to play. And so we have until May to make that decision, and we'll make that decision when it's appropriate. So we still got some time on Isaiah, but you know, I know Isaiah is an extremely talented player, and he's big, he's long, he's fast, and I think we'll be able to find a good way to use him this year.
How would you assess
how much the injuries attrition can be luck? How much? What kind of philosophy do you have on injury prevention going into a season?
Yeah, I think that's an important aspect of any football program. And I think injury prevention is right up there at the top. And I think anything that we can do to maximize the player's ability to improve their ability to stay on the field and develop their techniques, develop their physical skill set, those are all things that we got to look at. And anything that we can do to help the players achieve their max potential. That's something that we're going to look at, and it's a challenge for every NFL team, and it's one that we don't take lightly, and it's one that we're going to focus on moving forward.
Are there new horizons there, Monti?
Yeah, we had a chance to talk to DeMarcus. DeMarcus was a very impressive interview. I had known DeMarcus from my time in New England, and I wasn't surprised in the least at DeMarcus and the way he presented himself and his football knowledge. And you know, DeMarcus is a talented young coach, and he's got a bright future in this league.
How would you assess where you are on the defensive line right now?
Well, I would say that we have some players returning that are under contract. We have some others that are free agents and are up, and so we'll have to go through those discussions. I think, you know, there's some pieces in place up front. You know, Ledbetter played well last year. Leckie played well last year. You know, Rashard Lawrence, when we can, you know, he's got to prove that he can stay on the field, but when he's out there, he's been an effective player. So there's pieces out there that we can work around and we can build. But with every position on our team, we have to add. We have to add depth. We have to add talent. And those are things that we're going to look into doing at all positions on the team. I'm sorry, one more time?
The uniqueness of this year's draft class and the strengths of it in your mind.
Yeah, so, you know, I think there are certain positions that are stronger than others. I mean, you know, as I look at it, you know, tight end is a pretty unique position this year. It looks like there's a lot of quality and quantity there. I'd put that one right up there at the top of the list. You know, but we're in the middle of kind of our evaluation. We went through college meetings last week and going through that. That's one that stands out to me right now, tight ends. There's some other positions that do have some depth to it as well. But that's one that would probably stand out to me right now.
When you talk about Kyler's unique skill set, given the uncertainty of when exactly he's returning, how might that influence how you construct the roster or any sort of effect that might have?
Sure, and that's obviously a consideration, and Kyler is attacking his rehab, and it's been great to see him in the building and in the facility. You know, I think the priority with any player, and specifically Kyler, is getting him healthy and getting him on the field when he's ready to go and when he can do the things that he can do. And certainly we have to have a plan in place for if he's not ready to go. So, and we'll be ready for that, and we'll look at every avenue that we can to have our team ready so we can be competitive, and we will be ready for when Kyler's ready to go.
Right here. You had multiple interviews with Lou Anarumo. I was curious what your impressions of him as a head coaching candidate were, some of the takeaways you had from those.
Yeah, absolutely. Lou was an impressive candidate. Loved our time. We got a chance to speak to Lou a couple times. Lou was I'd heard great things about Lou, and he exceeded those expectations that I had for him. Lou's a great coach. He's done an excellent job at Cincinnati, and he represented himself very well in our time with him.
Monti, with the number 3 pick, how are you approaching that? Whereas, are you guys open for business to, you know, trade out of that?
Sure. I mean, you know, it's a position that I hope that we're not in too many more years. You know, it's one of those that it presents an opportunity that there's going to be a good player there for us to take at number 3, and so we'll be prepared to pick a player at number 3. You know, and we'll also our phones will be open, and I'm open to hearing any conversation about anybody that's willing to come up. And so, you know, I think with that number 3 pick, it's an opportunity to add a player. It's an opportunity to potentially get some calls on that pick. You know, and ultimately we'll make the best decision for us at the time. But you know, unfortunately, when we lose those games, it presents that number 3 pick and one we don't want to be in again. But we'll deal with it, and it presents a good opportunity for us this year.
Monti, I know the guy's just gotten.
Sure. I mean, I think everybody in the league is looking for that guy that we can build around long term. And there's a guy here that's under contract long term. And so Kyler brings a unique skill set to the table. He puts a lot of stress on defenses with both his arms and his legs. And so, you know, I think getting our new offensive staff to put a system in place that maximizes his talent, I mean, I think it presents a great opportunity for us moving forward. But ultimately, we got to get Kyler to a point where he's healthy and he can get back to doing the things that he can do on the field.
With the college assistants, I know that they just kind of got in the building, but how are you going to lean on them and their expertise as you
you guys get into the scouting process with the coaches?
Yeah, I think that's one advantage that hiring some of these college coaches has. They bring some institutional knowledge of players. It may be players that they coached, it may be players that they recruited, and so those are things that we're going to lean on. I'm a fan of any information, as long as it's good information, helps us in our evaluation process, and so we will gather all that we can from them, and we will use that to help us paint a picture of each prospect that they have some intimate knowledge of, and we'll use that to our advantage as we begin to evaluate these players.
Can you talk about just the three defensive guys, Jalen Carter, Will Anderson, and Tyree Wilson, and what you like about those three guys?
Yeah, I mean, I probably not going to get in too many specifics. Those are three players that I have, studied, and we'll continue to study, and anxious to meet with them and do more work with them this week. Those are three talented players, and they all bring different skill sets, and they've had good college careers. So we're excited to dive more into them and see exactly how they would fit for our team moving forward.
What did you learn in the short term that you worked with Adrian Wilson, and was it kind of disappointing to see him or exciting to see him get an opportunity?
I would say both at the same time. Yeah, I mean, Adrian was around for a few weeks when I first started, and he was able to go through some UFA meetings with us, the unrestricted free agency meetings, and I enjoyed our week. We had a great week together there. This is a great opportunity for him. I know what he's meant to this organization as a player and as a personnel executive. I'm sad to see him go, but I'm also excited for him and this new chapter and this opportunity for him to go back to his home state and go to the Panthers organization. So, excited for him, disappointed to see him that he won't be with us.
Cap space, there's a lot of room for you to bring back guys and sign guys. You're not really binded by a financial burden here, are you?
Everybody would always love to have more cap space, there's always going to be a trade-off if you make a decision to sign somebody and then you gotta cut somewhere else. So there's always a financial consideration that goes into everything, and finding the right value and putting the right role on a player and how they fit with our team. So, I think those are all important, that we make the sound financial and we be fiscally disciplined as we make our roster decisions. And so those are all going to go factor into our unrestricted free agency, retaining our own, and going out and adding any players.
Have you gotten calls about the third pick, or these days do you get texts about the third pick?
No, it's still pretty early in that process. So,
no calls.
No, those calls typically don't start till further down the road. So there's plenty of time for that.
Yeah. You've got a new assistant GM, you're the new GM, new head coach. You guys making any changes to the uniforms? The uniforms have been around for about 20 years. Any thoughts on that?
That is there's a lot of areas that are out of my areas of expertise, and I'd put that one up there too. I don't know. I like the bird. I like the Cardinal. It's the same logo as my high school way back in the day, so I kind of like it. I don't know. We'll cross that. They'll tell me what's going on with the jersey when we get to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's an interesting time in college football, and I think the people in college football are dealing with some uncharted waters there a little bit, and it is having an effect on us as well. I think we saw it this year in the quarterback market a little bit. There's a lot of quarterbacks that could have come out for the draft and chose to go a different route and to go back to school. So, we have seen some effect in just the supply, the number of quarterbacks specifically, and there's other players as well that have gone back. So, does that even out? Does that continue to be the case? I don't know. I think we're all kind of waiting and seeing how this will affect, but it certainly has had the effect on the number of players that have come out.
With quarterbacks specifically, I mean, does it matter that there's fewer? It seems like a ton of guys who were like late round grades, maybe PFA guys, went back to school. Does it matter that those guys aren't in this draft class?
I it's hard to say because of when they made those decisions, the evaluation process was still kind of midstream there. And so there was a long way to go in that. So, to say that, guys would have been draft picks or wouldn't have been draft picks, I'm not sure. That's probably a little early to call that. I think it's really just the sheer number of players that has been the biggest effect with NIL.
Monty, what's more important, what you see if they do participate in the combine drills or the FaceTime you get privately with the prospect?
Yeah, and I think for us, the most important thing that we get out of this week is the medical evaluations, is the players being here and having our doctors and having our trainers getting a chance to examine the players and just finding out where they are physically. And really the second most important thing that I get out of this is the face-to-face time when we interview with the players. And that's been great. We started that last night, both in the formal settings and the informal meetings that our coaches are doing. Those have been great. And those, we get a lot out of those meetings, and we'll continue to work through those this week. And then we'll get into the workouts as well. Those are important as well. But I'd put the medical and the interviews up above the on-field workouts.
How would you evaluate your cornerback group as it stands, and what you could do with the top-end guys who are available in the draft?
That's certainly another position where we need to add some players. Byron is a free agent, so we have to go through that situation. Marco is under contract, and we have a couple other players that are under contract as well. It's similar to other positions on our team where there's pieces in place, some guys that have played good ball last year. Christian Matthew got some good snaps last year as well. And so there's areas where we have some guys to build upon and build around, and there's areas where we're going to have to add some players to that position as well.